What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Apple gives a motto to each and every one of their devices, but they never have a motto for themselves. But if they did, it would probably go something like this: lighter, thinner, faster. That's it. However, the motto for the all-new iPad Air 2 is changes in the air, because it's that thin. In fact, it's so thin that they had to put a pencil, and then they lasered off like half the pencil to show just how thin this thing is. So apparently, this thing is much, much, much lighter, weighing at 0.96 pounds, and that basically means that hopefully we'll be able to hold it in our hands for a lot longer, and hopefully be able to use it just a lot better. Next off, of course, we get ourselves something pretty cool, and that's of course that the display is a lot better. Its resolution is now 2048x1536, which is pretty nice. The inch display is of course still the same. It comes in at 9.7 inches with 3.1 million pixels and 264 pixels per inch. Something new is the fact that it now comes with a reflective coating, so that is pretty nice in case you're using your device outside, or in case you just want it to be nice and glare-free. No more buying those weird screen protectors. The power has also been upgraded, as I said, speed, so it now has a 64-bit architecture A8X chip, which is actually better than the iPhone 6's chip, so keep that in mind. It's 2.5 times faster graphics and a 40% faster CPU. What's a little confusing is, what do you mean 40% faster? Is that 40% faster than the A8, 40% faster than last year's iPad, or 40% faster in general? I'm not sure about that, and they didn't really go in depth on that. It also maintains a solid 10 hours of battery life, which is pretty nice, and I don't think they upgraded the battery itself, but they did maintain its battery life, so people really like that. Now, security-wise, they did add Touch ID, which they should have done last year since that was last year's whole thing, but a lot of people were asking for it on a tablet. Since tablets just happen to get stolen a lot more than phones, you might leave it lying around, and tablets just are more personal. Although your phones may be personal, you may actually give your phone to a friend for them to like look at random things. Well, on the other hand, business people, they use tablets. They don't want anyone else messing with their information. Their work stuff's on there. So security is pretty important. And it is really annoying typing in a password every single time you unlock your device. So hopefully having Touch ID there will improve that. Next off, we get ourselves the cameras, and the cameras haven't changed too much, but the eyesight cameras themselves have been upgraded. It now includes slow-mo. You can now capture time-lapse videos. It also has a FaceTime HD camera as well, and video calls and selfies should be a lot easier to take. Megapixel-wise, it's at 8 megapixels for the back one, and it's front-facing camera. No one really cares about megapixels as long as you can see your face. But if you want the full list of specs, feel free to Google them, because Google is our best friend. See what I did there? Okay, anyhow, let's keep going with the iPad Air 2. I'm not used to saying that. I like the name iPad Air. It's short and simple. Now I gotta add a 2 after that. It does run on iOS 8, which will be nice and efficient, and you'll be able to multitask nice and fast. And it comes with a smart cover, which sadly did not get upgraded like I predicted. And that's it, guys. I think you guys now know why I was completely and utterly disappointed. There was nothing new, and as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, it was lighter, thinner, faster, and there's Touch ID. Now you guys are like, okay, that's a pretty decent amount of features, right? Well, let me put it into perspective. Them making a tablet lighter and thinner doesn't really benefit us, although some may think that, oh, it's lighter, in the end, our hands will get tired no matter what, and we'll prefer to use the tablet with its case and have it lying on a table and then type away at it. That's just the tablet world, unless they make it like paper light or something. But why do they keep doing it? Because they save money. Less metal, less parts, less battery space. The more they squish everything together, and the thinner they make everything, the more money they save, right? But think about it that way. Next off, let's talk about speed. So everyone loves a little bit more enhancements to the speed, but once again, nothing new. You just took whatever you had from last year and you added you took whatever you got from the iPhone 6 and you added an X afterwards, and you added a few more transistors, which pretty much cannot be that hard. It's faster, which is great, but in the end, the iPad Air was fast enough to multitask efficiently, and what we really wanted to see was another gig of RAM. Enough with your transistors and all that stuff. I want another gig of RAM so I can run a billion different applications at once, rather than have to close them out just to save battery and things like that. But that's my opinion. The final thing is Touch ID. That was improvement, and that was very, very important. But once again, that's from last year. Why didn't last year's iPad come with this feature? Like, really, Apple? In the end, I will probably end up getting this, mostly because I need to jailbreak it eventually, and this is going to be my main Apple device, hopefully. But I may also go with the 64 or 32GB iPad Air. The differences aren't that big. It's not like you got a bigger screen or turned into some wicked device. I don't even know what they could do to it with sapphire glass. I don't know. So yeah, I don't know. I'll have to make the decision. What do you guys think? Should I go with this year's iPad Air and pay who knows how much more? Or get last year's and save a nice $100? Or get extra memory? I don't know. I'm thinking about it, guys. I think I said I don't know like 18 times. Anyhow, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If so, leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. I was not trying to go against Apple, but Apple, please try to do something new. I'm a little tired of all this lighter, thinner, faster business. Thank you for watching. This is going to be me, locking off.